see all the good things on KGMB 9 tonight.
CSI tonight, right after Survivor on CBS. It's all here.
Please, 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 please. Oh, Simon. Oh, thank God you're okay. I was so worried. I called Isaac and he didn't know where you were. I was so... I'm sorry. I know I wasn't supposed to be here when you got back, but you were so angry when you left.
That's right, Katie. I was angry. I don't like being lied to. I can't believe I actually bought it. I actually thought you were pregnant.
I know. I should have never done that to you, and I understand why you're so angry. I shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry. I wanted to be here just in case something happened. I thought you might...
What? Like, drive my car through someone else's living room? No, my days of being an interior designer are over.
I just had this stupid idea that you might be on a plane back to Australia.
It's not so stupid. I drove around for hours thinking about doing just that.
What did you decide?
Nothing much, I bet. But of course, you don't know everything that I know.
All right, it may be time for another visit with the prisoner.
The one from Hong Kong?
Yeah, Mei-Lin Chang. She's refusing to sign her statement. Go tell her I'm on my way and tell her I expect to hear that she has re-evaluated her options.
How long do you think she can hold out?
Well, it better not be much longer, because if she doesn't spill soon, I'm going to lose Craig Montgomery, and if I lose him, I'm going to lose her. Just go tell her what I said.
I know that you're busy and I'm interrupting, but there's something that you need to see.
What is it?
Something I think that may change your mind.
If it's about Montgomery, forget it, because nothing's gonna do that.
This is not about Craig. This is about our son.
Mr. Winthrop. Oh, please, call me Cass.
Cass, Craig Montgomery.
Thank you for coming. I took the liberty of ordering a little snack. Have a seat.
Oh, thank you. Oh, this looks great. Your sister was very persuasive when she called me and asked me to take you on as a client.
The brief sketch she gave me was nothing if not intriguing. She said something about wanting me to see a man about a horse.
I'm trying to establish ownership.
And you think you should be owner because? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
Cheers. Because the horse was purchased by my late partner with money I gave him to invest.
Invest in what?
Something other than a horse.
So you did not authorize the purchase of a stallion by the name of Flashdance?
I didn't even know about it. My partner died suddenly and left his entire estate to his widow, a woman named Carly Tenney.
And you think that Ms. Tenney won't want to give you fair return on your investment? I take that as a no. Margot mentioned that you'd like me to broker a compromise between you and the widow Tenney. Is that right?
Not exactly. What I'd like you to do, counselor, is make absolutely sure that I get the horse and Miss Tenney doesn't get a dime.
Julia?
Hello.
Can you talk?
Not really. I just got home. Julie's probably right upstairs.
Then I need to see you. Jack, I can't stop thinking about Hal threatening to keep me away from Parker.
I'm sure he didn't mean it. Look, he's not acting like himself. I'll talk to him.
I'm scared, Jack. Please, we're at the Riverfront Park. I need to see you for just a few minutes. It's not that far away. Could you swing it?
I'll try.
All right, now hurry up. I don't think Parker's gonna last too much longer here. We're at the sandbox. I love you.
Me too. Hi, yes, this is Detective Snyder for Dr. Michaels. Yes, I'll hold.
Dr. Michaels? You checking up on me, Jack?
I called out to you when I came in, but you didn't answer, so I was just calling to see if you were at Dr. Michael's office.
Nope. Here. I was sleeping. I had the weirdest dreams. Must have been those pills she gave me.
What pills?
Oh, it's no big deal. Just something to help me sleep. Whatever it was, they made me really hungry. How about I throw together one of those romantic little suppers for two?
I didn't know you were having trouble sleeping.
Well, why worry you? You've had a lot on your mind these days. That's why I want us to have a nice romantic dinner together to take advantage of the fact that you're...
So, when's your next appointment?
Don't have one.
She didn't think it was necessary for you to come back?
I didn't think it was necessary, Jack. Can I make any decisions about my own life?
No, I just think that you need to keep seeing your doctor.
Why?
Because the kind of depression that you've been in since you lost the baby, Julia, from everything I've read, it just doesn't go away on its own. I want to help you.
You know what would help? If we started trying again. Once I have a baby to look forward to, I know I'll be fine. We both will.
There is a rhythm to life. We sleep at night and wake in the morning. It's this sleep cycle that helps keep us in a healthy balance. But for millions of Americans, sleep doesn't always come easy. Fortunately, there's Ambien. Ambien is a prescription sleep aid that can help you get a full night's sleep. With Ambien, you fall asleep fast, stay asleep longer, and generally wake without feeling groggy the next morning. No wonder Ambien is the number one prescribed sleep aid in America. Until you know how Ambien will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Side effects may include drowsiness, dizziness, and diarrhea. You shouldn't take it with alcohol. Patients who abuse prescription sleep aids may become dependent. Prescription sleep aids are most often taken for 7 to 10 days as needed. Your doctor will advise you about taking them longer. Take Ambien only when you can devote a full night to sleep and wake up rested and ready to start your day. Talk to your doctor about Ambien. Ambien works like a dream.
Sis, I snooped in your medicine cabinet.
So?
You switched to X-Lax.
Yeah, Correctol works with an artificial chemical. X-Lax works with natural senna.
Very effectively, too.
You tried it.
What a find.
What a snoop.
Good morning, guaranteed.
Did you hear that?
That's the sound of the special kind of clean we quilt into every sheet of Quilted Northern.
Black tissue doesn't have it.
All that quilting leaves you feeling clean.
Squeaky clean.
Quilted Northern for a quilted clean.
Got your Pop-Tarts?
Yeah, got it.
Got my toaster strudel?
Of course. When are you gonna get your own toaster strudel?
Pillsbury toaster strudel. Like Pop-Tarts, only better. Warm, flaky pastry, juicy fruit filling, and do-it-yourself icing.
So, what do you do with all those Pop-Tarts?
Something better just popped up in your grocer's freezer.
Pillsbury toaster strudel.
You're about to see a toothbrush do something rather unusual. The Colgate Navigator. It bends wide open, so its bristles gently adjust to your teeth for a thorough clean. The Colgate Navigator. Bent on cleaning better.
When you have an ailment, different doctors might recommend different treatments. But for yeast infections, the number one recommendation of doctors is specific. Monistat, the number one doctor-recommended brand, Monistat.
Who will win the fight to raise Spencer? 48 hours tonight. For three bachelors, the only thing more dangerous than vicious kidnappers...
Where's the money?
...is the baby they're trying to protect. All new Diagnosis, CBS Friday.
What is it, Jack? Did I say something wrong?
No, of course not. I mean, I can understand why you'd want to start thinking about having another baby, Julia, but it's too soon.
Why?
Because we just lost one. You can't just rush right off and try to have another one. They're not interchangeable. We've got to work through the loss of this one first.
Is that what's going on between us? The grieving period?
That would make sense, wouldn't it?
Is that why you haven't wanted to touch me? Because of what my body did?
No. What? How could you even say that?
You said it.
earlier that I lost the baby.
No, Julia, I do not blame you for... Look, I'm not going to suddenly stop caring about you, Julia. I will always care.
Then make love to me.
I will. But the doctor said we had to wait.
Right. A while. And a while is over, as of today. In fact, that's why I thought you came home early, because you remembered that.
I'm sorry, but I can't. Hal called as soon as I walked through the door, and he needs me to go into the station.
You just got here.
I know. It's a departmental meeting I completely forgot about.
Okay. I just wish...
What?
I wish that you would let me hold you again.
I'm sorry. I know this has been really unfair to you.
Life's unfair. But I'll get through it, Jack. Just as long as I have you.
I gotta go.
I'll wait all night.
The way I see it, my claim completely supersedes Carly's, because the horse was purchased with my money.
So you just have to be able to prove that the transaction actually took place.
My partner and I made our deal with a handshake.
You seem far too savvy to me to not get things down in writing. Am I to assume that this deal was not your average everyday business venture?
I can't go into detail.
But without legal documentation proving that you were owed money, no court will award you any. In fact, as things stand now, the court will side with Ms. Tenney. Not only is she the widow, but she also has that little piece of paper that entitles her to the horse. You don't.
Well, I'm not going to sit back and watch her spend my money.
Look, I really wish I could help you, but without the documentation, I'd have nothing to fight with, so... It was nice to meet you. Lovely Merlot. Good luck. You know, you might take your brother-in-law's advice.
What did he say?
Well, he suggested that you make a friend of this woman. Maybe then she'll play fair and do the honorable thing.
You don't know Carly. Underneath her damsel in distress act beats the heart of a cornered rat.
Well, she's not going to be in distress much longer. She's going to be rich.
No.
Unless...
Do go on.
Well, unless you were able to come up with something that she values more than money.
Now you're thinking like a lawyer.
When did you get this?
I just came from the conference with Will's teacher. She's very worried about him.
Why? There's nothing wrong with Will. He's a great kid.
Yes, he is a great kid. Miss Barnes adores him. That's why she's so worried about him. Hal, you can't ignore this. Will is withdrawn, and he's sullen. And what does she say in there?
Uncommunicative. What does she want? A show-off who's always demanding attention?
No, she wants Will Munson, the little boy she had in her class before Christmas. He's a different kid since he's come back since vacation.
Well, I don't see it. If he's so uncommunicative, how come he's always Mr. Sunshine at home?
Because there's no room for his problems at home. Because he's so full of anger and hurt, he keeps thinking that if he's a good little boy, and he's sweet, and he's kind, and he cracks jokes at dinner, that maybe his mommy and daddy will forget all about the divorce.
What do you think we should do? Send him to a child psychologist?
I think that's a start. But I think there's something else we need to do.
What?
We need to make our son understand that our marriage is our responsibility, not his. And that means we make everyone in our life know where we stand on this. It's time for a resolution, Hal.
Right. And I have almost got it, Barbara. You give me a few hours because I am this close to giving you something to read that will make you forget about Greg Montgomery forever.
You know what? I'm talking to a wall here, Hal. You shove your pain and your anger at the kids the whole time, and all they keep thinking is that maybe their mommy will come to their senses and their parents will stay married.
Is that what you think I'd do? You think I would use the kids
that
to hang
is
on
not
to you?
What I am saying.
I am just telling you that we have to agree not to keep them in limbo anymore. It's not fair to them.
What about any of this is fair?
We owe it to our children and to each other to make the final step. Once these are signed, Hal, some of the pain will end.
You want out? You got out. Here's your resolution. What keeps you warm at night?
I'm sure Simon doesn't need your help deciding whether or not to go back to Australia, so if you wouldn't mind.
I wouldn't mind. I mean, you go, you stay, do whatever you like. Shut the door, though. You'll get pneumonia. Well, Lily's gone. Far, far away. A very long, long vacation with her children.
Yeah, I know. I know all that.
Yeah? But what you couldn't possibly know, even in this information age, is that before she left, she was told about the encounter that your car had with my house. And she left anyway. Without even a phone call, right?
So what? So what, is this the part where I'm supposed to collapse, broken by the news? Well, if that's right, you really should have saved your ticket stub.
No, I'm actually delighted that you're not devastated. And I'll tell Lily when she calls that you took the news of her departure with a smile.
I bet you will. You seem to love putting me in the worst possible light with her. So what did you do? What did you... Did you lay it on till she was completely turned off, till she couldn't wait to get out of Oakdale?
Holden was home. True blue Holden. So there were no lies, there was no exaggeration, and there were no omissions, because he wanted her to know everything that had happened so that she could have her own reaction. Well, she did waver for a second or so, and then, thank heavens, she realized that if she rushed to your rescue, she would cause herself more pain.
So it was as simple as that?
In the end. And you do know why, don't you, darling? She never really loved you. You were an infatuation. Yeah, infatuations are wonderful. I mean, it's a flame, and it's got a lot of energy and heat, but then it spends itself. And it's out.
So why are you here? What did you come around to gloat? Like some fight fan watching a boxer get slammed? Is that it? Fine, I'm slammed. I'm down for the count. You got your money's worth after all. Now get out.
I believed you the other night when you said you loved her. But darling, you took something that didn't belong to you. Now, I think you're smart. And I don't think that you're a man who would make the same mistake twice.
Falling in love with Lily was not a mistake.
You have to forget Lily, just as she's forgotten you.
Is there anything else?
You know, you shouldn't believe all my press. I'm not really a bad guy all the time. I can sometimes be a veritable angel, like today. I mean, I haven't come here to rejoice in your defeat. I've come to help you.
Help me? Do what?
Make up your mind.
V. these two women started scrubbing their bathtubs at the same time. The woman on the right used new scrubbing bubbles, the bathroom cleaner with deeper penetrating bubbles that cut through soap scum faster and easier than ever. The woman on the left is using Tilex. Be done with scum faster with new scrubbing bubbles. Now they work even harder, so you don't have to. S.C. Johnson, a family company.
Vandekamp's fillets. That's it. Hey, that's new. Marinated shrimp. Tenders? I love tenders.
The irresistible taste of Vandekamp seafood makes it easy to love again and again and again. Vandekamp's, the fish and shrimp you can't resist.
What a lovely breeze. Oh. Dear fresh-minded consumer, blue sky, fresh breezes, is there anything that feels cleaner? Well, maybe yours truly. I'm Cottonelle Toilet Paper, the only toilet paper with cushy ripples, specially designed to leave you feeling fresh, dry, and confidently clean. Ah, it's like a breath of fresh air. Cottonelle, when you think of clean, think of me.
Maybe it's not the kids that are wearing you out.
Maybe it's hormones. They fluctuate as early as your 30s.
Don't wait till menopause to get Estrovan,
a complete formula with plant estrogens to help balance hormones naturally,
gently,
safely.
Don't wait till menopause to get Estrovan.
Hot showers, shaving, cold weather cause not just dry skin, but dry, itchy skin. Only Neutrogena Soothing Relief Moisturizer has three medicated ingredients to bring both instant and lasting relief. Neutrogena Soothing Relief Moisturizer. It works.
Let me ask you this. If I have to rinse my dishes, then put them in the dishwasher, take them out, and pick off the food, why do I have a dishwasher?
Electrosol can solve that problem for you because Electrosol has dual-action tabs. With an effervescent blue layer that gets your dishes clean and shiny the first time.
Thank you.
Problem solved. Electrosol.
My friend is still at the INS. He's functioning, he's effective. We can get the charges dropped against you, okay? And then you can use my lawyer, if you want to dissolve your marriage to this Martha Stewart wannabe.
Hey!
And then you can go home. I will send you home. First class. With cash in your jeans. Cash. You can start all over again at home, in style. What do you say?
I say some things never change. Maybe you've forgotten, but this sounds exactly like the same bargain that you offered me months ago.
You just have to face up to something, darling. You were part of a dream that Lily had. And she dreamed, and then she woke up. And she saw the devastation, the pain to Holden. She has taken responsibility for that pain and has gone away to recoup, but she will come back. And when she comes back, she's going to come back to Holden. Holden will be waiting.
Whatever.
So, I think we got two options, two choices. You can take my never-to-be-repeated offer and go home. Or you can stay here and you can do battle with the INS and you can try to prove to them that you just love and want to be married to this girl, the wrong girl. I don't get you, kids. I don't get you. I think you're smart. So prove me right.
Can you believe that woman? You're not gonna take her offer, are you? Listen, I will get a job. We will move out of this place.
As far as I'm concerned, Katie, you've already moved out. I need a shower. I gotta think.
About us?
About everything.
Divorce papers. I guess I didn't realize that this was gonna happen so soon.
Yes, well, there was no sense in waiting because it was inevitable. So I'm going to get on a plane and go down to the Dominican Republic.
And in a couple of days, this will all be over. And then I will come home and attempt to clean up the mess.
A whole marriage over in a couple of days. Just, what does Hal think about you going to the Dominican Republic?
I didn't tell him that little detail. He never would have signed the papers if I had. And we've got to get this over. Jennifer is furious and Will is sullen and Hal just keeps dragging this marriage on, and it's hurting my children every day.
I know, I still can't believe this is happening.
Come on, Julia, you know what I've been going through for this better part of this last year. My life has been a battleground, and there's been very little times of peace. You can't live like that.
I know, but I thought that you and Hal had everything. Then again, I thought that I was going to have a baby, so.
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be dumping all this on you.
No. It's not your fault. It's mine. I thought that I could make a safe little world for me and Jack. And now I feel like I'm inside a snow globe and somebody keeps turning it upside down.
Listen. There's nothing about this world that's safe. As a cop's wife, I thought you'd know that by now.
You're not gonna be the wife of a cop anymore.
Nope.
I'm gonna miss that. I used to love thinking about the four of us and how we would go through everything together, you know? We would share everything. We'd watch our children getting married.
What was happening to Hal and me was always going to happen to Hal and me. We just cheated fate out of a little time. You know, I think that you need a glass of wine along with me, because I think this is not about my divorce. Why don't you tell me what's going on?
You have to promise not to tell anyone.
Not a soul.
Jack is seeing Carly again.
Oh. Oh, no.
He lies about it all the time.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry. What are you gonna do?
Well, I'm not giving up. I'm gonna handle Carly, and I know exactly how to do it.
Well, G-Man, I guess you're not gonna make it.
All right, Parker, let's go home.
Carly.
Hey, look. Look who's here.
Hey, buddy.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you for coming. I can't stop my mind from cooking up this worst-case scenario. I keep thinking that everything is going to start spinning out of control again,
Jack. It won't, as long as we stay on the level with each other. You got to tell me everything, Carly, even if you think I'd be better off not knowing. Promise?
I promise.
So, what's going on?
Well, you know how Hal wants me to tell him everything that Craig had to do with Winston's...
Hey, Parker, let's get your bucket and shovel here. I'll race you to the sandbox. You ready? Come on. Here. My good spot.
Hey. There you go.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Come on, Billy.
You got a fast guy on your hands
there. He's happy, you know. You know, kids, you're always so excited to see what life has to offer next. I don't want to change that in him. That's why I don't want to talk about Hal in front of him. I don't think he needs to hear that I'm worried that Hal's going to lose it over Craig and Barbara.
Well, he's got a lot of us concerned these days.
He's being completely irrational, Jack. Using Parker to get me to pin some sort of murder rap on Craig?
Hey, Parker, honey. Stay in the sandbox, okay?
Look at him. Jack, I don't think I could bear to lose him again. I wish we were married. Then nobody, not Craig or Hal, nobody could ever do anything to me again.
I've got to tell you something. It's not good news.
Julia.
I was hoping that once I finally got her into therapy that she'd be better. But I don't know. It's almost as if she's worse. And she says she's not going back. According to her, she doesn't need to. But she's acting really strange, Carly. And I'm afraid that she's never going to get over this. And how can I tell her about us if...
I'm sorry. For her. For us, for everything. You know, at night, when I'm lying in bed and I'm scared that I will never make it out of this nightmare, I think about our house. The house you're gonna build for us up on that hill you bought. And I decorate it, room by room. And by the time I've got all the walls painted and the curtains hung in our room, I can sleep. That's why I want that horse, Jack. So we can build our own place, someplace really safe where nobody can ever hurt us again.
Parker? Parker? No, honey! Don't go in front of the swings! Parker!
Counselor, I urge you to continue.
Urge? Urge.
I've got the urge.
She's got the urge to burble. She ran the burble in the shower.
Order!
For another half an hour. She's got the urge. Natural botanical. She's got the urge to burble.
Order!
I hope those boys show up for the body wash.
Hey, come on and grab a bite. Do the Cool Whip light. Do the Cool Whip. It's the taste of pure delight. And it feels so right when it's Cool Whip light. Cool Whip.
Now that I only have to change my cat litter once every 30 days, I feel so smart, lazy, guilty, free.
Teddy Cat's Crystals. It's time to change your cat litter. Less often.
I'm feeling good. I'm taking Wellbutrin SR, an antidepressant with a low risk of sexual side effects. That's important to me.
Wellbutrin SR is clinically proven to effectively treat depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
Glad I talked to my doctor. Wellbutrin SR works for my depression.
Be open with your doctor. Ask about Wellbutrin SR. It treats depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
Wellbutrin SR is not for everyone. There is a risk of seizure. To reduce that risk, don't use if you have or have had a seizure or eating disorder. Don't use if you take Zyban or an MAOI. When used with a nicotine patch or alone, there is a risk of increased blood pressure, sometimes severe. To reduce risk of serious side effects, tell your doctor if you have liver or kidney problems. Other side effects may include dry mouth, nausea, and difficulty sleeping.
I'm feeling like myself again.
Ask your doctor about Wellbutrin SR, clinically proven to treat depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
There's no other bar quite like it. The White Stripes are a moisturizing cleanser. The Pink Stripes have a nourishing lotion with vitamin E. These keep you clean and soft. These replenish your skin's essential nutrients. They work together to create Dove Nutrium. The first dual formula bar that does more than just clean and moisturize. It nourishes your skin to a healthy, radiant glow.
Claimed his innocence, but when Dr. Richard Kimball robs a bank,
give me all the money.
It will challenge everything you thought you knew
Kimball!
About the fugitive. An all-new episode. Then, the only thing more shocking than this crime.
You got something to say?
I didn't kill nobody.
Is how this episode ends. An all-new Nash Bridges, CBS Friday.
There's something about Frankie's new roommate he doesn't know.
Autographed photo of Bette Midler.
You think he's Jewish?
Some of my best friends.
You're not Jewish.
Series premiere, CBS Wednesday.
Why is it that some people have more energy?
can hit the day running. Smile in the face of adversity. Just ask one of our members. Call now and get 2-for-1 or 50% off for yourself. 24-hour fitness. It's the way we make you feel.
Now that schools have computers, we need more of them.
That's why Fula makes it easy to find computers.
In the Shop for Better Education program.
Just shop my Kai and you'll earn points.
Or you and your selected school.
Anyone can take part.
So shop often at Fula and Faculty.
And help put more computers
into the hands of kids.
We're gonna have sex and we're gonna drink.
And you can't stop us.
On the next mark, there's no telling what these 13-year-olds will do.
I had sex 15 times and with 6 different guys.
They stole clothes, jewelry, money.
She's destroyed my family.
All from our own offices. But with the help of hidden cameras, we caught them.
I don't want to see my family cry.
My team caught on tape on the next mark.
Today at 3 on KGMB9. Tonight on KGMB 9 News, it was a happy day at the circus that ended in tragedy. Tyke the Elephant goes on a rampage. On the streets of Honolulu, Steve Hirano recalls that day. Hawaii survivor, Circus Stampede. Tonight on KGMB 9 News.
Aloha, I'm Stephanie Lum. A local documentary on Waikiki previews for the first time. Watch KGMB 9 News for the latest local news at 5 and 6 tonight.
From the producers of Erin Brockovich, Kate Brasher, series premiere CBS Saturday.
Okay, Parker. It's all right, honey. Mama's here, baby.
Is he all right? And I'm so sorry. He walked in front of the swing before.
No, it's my fault. I should have been with him.
Hey, take my handkerchief. Put pressure on the cut, okay?
There's so much blood, Jack.
Yeah, I know. It's a head wound. All right, let's get him to the hospital.
Yeah, I need to call for a cab. We took the bus here, Jack. Yeah. Parker wanted to ride on the
bus. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. I'll drive you. Let's go.
So if I find something that Carly wants more than money from the sale of that horse, I've got
leverage, I believe it's called. You still won't have a case. But if you've got the right leverage, you might not need one. Of course, leverage isn't always easy to find.
Ooh, I got her leverage. Carly's not a huge mystery. She has a few problems controlling her emotions.
Hey, then maybe you'll be in business after all.
Maybe we might be in business. Counselor, I do believe I'd like you to represent me.
Well, good. Then I'll need a retainer from you by the close of business today.
That doesn't give me much time. Well, why don't we see if we're able to work together? And if we aren't, I'll pay you for the hours you've accrued. And if we are, then we might possibly just get richer together.
You really need that horse, don't you?
Well, I want that horse. It's mine.
Not because you're broke? Yeah, I thought so.
And I thought lawyers knew better than to make inferences without proof.
Inferences? Don't kid a kidder.
Excuse me. Hello. Carly? What? How about me? Oh, well, I'm sure he'll be fine then. Yes. I'll bring the teddy bear. All right, is there anything else you want me to bring? All right, I'll see you there. Speak of the she-devil.
You have her teddy bear?
Well, I have her son's. Did I mention she lives with me?
No, I think I would have remembered that.
Excuse me, I have another call to make.
Sure, no problem. Craig.
Yes, I need to get a message to Lieutenant Munson, please. It's an emergency. His son Parker has been taken to the emergency room at Memorial Hospital.
Here's a word of advice for you. Never underestimate that gentleman over there. It's, too expensive. Yeah, keep the change.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, did you pay? Next time, my treat.
No. Don't give it another thought.
Yes?
It's perfectly fine.
Well, thank you.
What's with the good deed for Munson? I was under the distinct impression that you and the lieutenant were not friends.
I wanted to do him a favor. And you know that thing that Carly wants more than money? She just dropped it in my lap. I'll tell you about it on the way to Memorial. But you only work with a retainer.
Or if I have a specific interest in a case. And so far, I must admit, what you lack in funds, you more than make up for in suspense. Going along for the ride might just be payment enough.
Excellent. I look forward to a long and profitable relationship.
Thank you, Raul.
How's our prisoner now?
Miss Chang is still demanding a lawyer, but now she wants to be charged or released.
Well, I don't care what she wants. There is no lawyer, there is no deal, there is no nothing until she rolls over on Craig Montgomery for murder. You got that? What's your problem, Grady?
Look, I don't know how much longer we can deny her an attorney. It's a little irregular.
You want to hear irregular? I'll tell you irregular. Irregular is building a home and a family and then watching one guy wipe it all out.
Sir,
irregular is having a desk jockey telling me what to do. What?
The desk just got a call about your son, Parker. He's been taken to Memorial Emergency.
Quilted Always Ultra. With 6 times more absorbency than women normally need. Quilted Always Ultra. Always clean, always dry, always great protection. And for great protection without wings, try new Always Ultra Longs.
School could receive a $2,500 grant.
Look, Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Ellie's renting again.
And Enterprise picked her up again.
She said Enterprise picks her up free.
Free?
Free.
Now that makes renting easy.
Mm-hmm. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
You live with two teenagers. Whoa, life is a zoo.
And it's always feeding time.
I'm sure glad I found these.
Chef Boyardee overstuffed Italian sausage ravioli and spaghetti and jumbo meatballs for bigger kids with bigger appetites from Chef Boyardee.
What's this? It's new Ambipure, the only 2-in-1 liquid air freshener and bowl cleaner. Ambipure constantly freshens your bathroom and cleans the bowl for up to 30 days. New Ambipure, a whole new way to freshen your bathroom.
Your face has over 20,000 pores. Make them look smaller, your skin smoother, more even with Neutrogena Pore Refining Cream, the daily moisturizer with retinol and alpha hydroxy. Neutrogena Pore Refining Cream. This was worth waiting for.
The road in Huggies Ultra Trim diapers, lined with a pure and gentle lotion that helps protect against wetness, like water rolls off a car. For skin that looks good and healthy, Huggies keep skin drier than any other diaper.
This week,
no one is better than Edmund at spinning a lie and making it sound like the truth.
Will the Prince of Darkness reign?
You will never rule Centrus DeMille.
The royal face-off begins.
I am entirely fit to rule this country.
You're a liar.
And what happens next?
You must be stopped.
Is everything on Guiding Light?
Wild dingoes, intense heat, heart-stopping excitement. David Letterman surviving the Late Show. And tonight, don't miss Oscar nominee Benicio Del Toro.
Just thought I'd drop by and see how the expectant couple was doing. I see. Been crying, what's the matter? Marriage to Simon Fraser not all you thought it would be?
No. It's actually better.
And why the tears?
We lost the baby. And sometimes it just kind of gets to me. Simon, too.
Katie, do you know it?
Look who's here. Agent Hallowell. I guess Lucinda Walsh called him, said you had something to tell him.
Did she really?
I told him it wasn't the greatest day for a meeting with the miscarriage and everything.
I'm really surprised Lucinda Walsh contacted you.
I mean, nothing's changed that would be of interest to the INS.
Really?
Well, there is one notable exception. Lily Snyder's left town. I guess Miss Walsh was thinking that without her daughter around, you might have changed your mind about wanting that green card so badly. I mean, forgive my bluntness, but if you've lost the girl and you've lost the baby, what's to hold you here?
My wife? We're married and things are gonna stay that way. You know, sometimes the bond between a man and a woman gets stronger when you have a stroke of bad luck.
You know, for some reason, it still amazes me that you two play the game better than most. It'll be sad when I finally get enough evidence to bust you. But I will.
I'm glad that charade is over.
Are you really not going to take Lucinda's offer and stay? Sam, what made you change your mind?
Lucinda herself. I want to find out why she's so bound and determined to get me out of Oakdale before Lily gets back.
You have a little bit of work to do there, I would imagine. Huh?
John.
What is it?
Wait. Parker, what happened?
He got hit by a swing at the park.
Oh, my gosh. Lose consciousness?
No.
Let's see, Parker. Ooh, doesn't look too hot. A couple of stitches, I think. But I'll do them. I'll do them. You'll be okay. Maybe you look like a pirate when it's all over. Come on.
Please, can I want to be with
Why don't you wait here until I'm done? Come on, Parker.
Boy, John Dixon just doesn't quit with the attitude, does he?
It's okay. I'm used to it. Besides, there isn't any other doctor that I'd want taking care of Parker, so...
Somebody want to tell me what happened to my son?
Hal.
I got a call at the police station that Parker was hurt. Now, what happened?
There was an accident at the playground. No big deal. John Dixon's putting a couple stitches.
I was asking Carly. This is between us.
Jack, maybe it'd be better if you left. I'll be okay. Parker will, too. Thanks for getting us here. Now, I was just about to call you.
I'll save the excuses, Carly. None of them are gonna work this time. Parker got hurt. Now, why? Were you distracted? Something else on your mind, maybe, like Jack?
No. We were at the playground. How? Accidents happen at playgrounds every day.
I tried to give you a break. I tried to let you be part of Parker's life, but you blew it. Now, if you're not capable of taking care of him, you are not going to be part of his life anymore.
When a migraine's coming, you can feel it, so you should start fighting the pain fast with Advil Migraine, the only migraine medicine in a liquid-filled form. Start controlling the migraine before it takes control of you. Advil Migraine.
When you're a food critic, a cold could be a serious problem.
So, I take Advil Cold and Sinus. It's got the strength of Advil I trust, plus a powerful decongestant, so I can get back to work. That's why they call it Advil Cold and Sinus.
Excuse me, which brand of children's cold medicine have moms used more?
Dimetapp.
Yeah, but which brand is recommended most by pediatricians?
Dimetapp.
Oh.
Now, he's got to have something that tastes good.
Well, how about the great grape taste of Dimetapp?
And we've read we should use a cold medicine that's PPA-free.
Ah, well, in that case, I'd still go with Dimetapp.
New formula Dimetapp, the brand that's doctor-recommended, proven at home.
At GEICO, we're always looking for faster ways to process your car insurance claims. One idea, airlifting claims adjusters right to the site of the accident. We're over the target.
I don't see the car.
It's that little black dot.
They're all little black dots.
The laptop. Oh, your laptop.
GEICO Direct. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
You know, Capri Sun's all natural, which means I can pronounce everything in it. And ever since they made it easy open, the kids inhale it.
Easy open Capri Sun.
My dry, itchy skin would flare up. I just wanted to hide.
Cordate helps heal and protect dry, itchy skin fast with maximum strength medicine and special moisturizers.
My skin was healed.
First aid, fast aid, Cordate.
It's the humidity.
I overcooked it. Somehow I inherited my Uncle Lester's hair genes.
Don't excuse your hair. Infuse your hair with Infusium 23.
If your hair requires an explanation like mine, you need Infusium 23 shampoos, conditioners, and leave-in treatments. Infusium infuses my hair with 23 essential elements to repair, even strengthen it. See the difference?
Don't excuse your hair.
Infuse your hair
with Infusium 23.
Tonight on the highest-rated show, the castaways reach the breaking point.
Don't wave a finger in my face.
All-new Survivor. Then a Vegas showgirl murdered.
Seen anything you like?
The clues are everywhere. Can you solve the crime?
I got the DNA to prove it.
CSI Survivor. Two shows sweeping the nation. CBS Tonight.
Well, this day didn't turn out as I expected. If you had told me a couple hours ago that we'd still be married, I would have never believed you in a million years. But now, all of a sudden, there's hope.
Hope? Nothing has changed. Our marriage was based on a lie, and you've just been piling them on ever since.
I only told one lie, really, about the baby. All the other lies were there to support that lie. They were like sub-lies.
Sub-lies? What, so now you're putting all your lies into categories, is that right?
No, never mind. I'm not going to make any excuses anymore, okay? The only reason I lied about being pregnant is because I was so scared for months.
Scared of what?
Losing you to Lily.
Oh, I have told you. You cannot lose something that you never had. I never pretended to feel anything I don't. I never crossed the line. But you haven't been on the level since day one.
I know. I never should have listened to Henry. No, you know what? It wasn't even Henry. It's me. I don't know what's wrong with me. The past year, everything that I touched looked like gold and turned to dust.
Well, maybe you ought to think about changing the way you do things.
Do you think it's too late for a New Year's resolution?
Depends on what it is.
I do hereby resolve, swear, and promise not to play any more games with you. We are only roommates. That's it. And I will remember that. And if you want to see Lily again, then that's okay. And I'll cover for you with the INS just like I promised you from the very beginning, okay?
So no more lies? Sub-lies?
No. And if I keep my promise, do you think maybe we could just be friends again?
You're wrong, Hal. I had one eye on Parker the entire time. I just couldn't get to him fast enough.
Dr. Dixon wants you to know the stitches are almost done. Your son is doing fine.
I'm Parker's father. I will take him home when he's done.
Hal.
I'll tell Dr. Dixon.
Hal, you're being crazy. It isn't fair.
All fair has gotten me is sleepless nights worrying about Craig Montgomery's influence on my son, and now a trip to the emergency room. I am through with your definition of fair. And if I have my way, you won't be able to get within 10 feet of my boy.
Did you hear that, Counselor? Good. I wouldn't want Lieutenant Munson here to misunderstand the situation.
What are you doing here?
Carly asked me to bring this.
What about you, Cass?
Cass is working for me, Hal. And if he's working for me, he's working for Carly. To wit, Cass is here as Carly's lawyer.
I hope this doesn't sound too strange or anything, but, can we keep the conversation about Carly just between us?
Well, of course we can. I told you that.
Okay.
Are you all right? Are you sure?
No, but I'm going to be. I'm going to be.
I think we're going to be.
Yeah.
All right, kid. I'll talk to you soon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thanks. Bye. Bye.
Yes, hello. I just wanted to see if Detective Snyder was still in the divisional meeting.
Oh.
No. No message.
Okay.
deal with your kid's fever, sore throat, and stuffy nose like they've never been dealt with before. With new Children's Motrin Cold. Fast, long-lasting, it's a low blow to colds. New Children's Motrin Cold. For moms who don't fool around with colds.
The world just picked its number one anti-wrinkle cream. Nivea Visage Q10 Wrinkle Control. With your skin's own anti-aging coenzyme Q10.
Wrinkles, out of here.
Arrête le temps.
Thank you, Q10.
Only from Nivea.
Officers continuing the pursuit on the ground. The truck is crossing all lanes. He's turning off. He's spinning out. Patrol units have a block. Suspect moving. Suspect moving.
Can't get enough peanuts? Get a payday. Sweet caramel and tons of salty peanuts.
What it is. What it feels like. What it is. What it feels like. What it is. We know what social anxiety can feel like, and Paxil can help. Over 10 million people suffer from overwhelming anxiety that significantly impairs work or social life, and a chemical imbalance could be to blame. Paxil, the only medication proven effective for social anxiety disorder, works to correct this imbalance. Paxil is not for everyone. Tell your doctor what medicines you're taking. People taking MAOI should not take Paxil. Paxil side effects may include decreased appetite, dry mouth, sweating, nausea, constipation, sexual side effects in men and women, yawn, tremor, or sleepiness. With time, your doctor's help, and Paxil, life can feel like life again. Paxil, your life is waiting.
Oh, I don't believe this.
What? Well, look what she's using to clean that window.
Windex.
Ain't that what they're supposed to use?
Well, yeah, if you want a clean window. Ah, look at him, huh? He's got that other stuff nice and streaky.
Oh, come on. Windex even cleans what the other stuff leaves behind.
So? So, a bird could get hurt flying into a window like that. Come on, where are we going? There's a new car on Elm Street.
The difference is clear. For a streak-free shine every time, Windex is best on glass. S.C. Johnson, a family company.
CBS Sunday. A corporate challenge turns into a survival of the fittest. Now one man must outwit, outplay, and outlast the angels.
The game's over.
Harry Hamlin, all new, touched by an angel. Then.
It's only one man. It isn't just one man. Got it. It's Zorro.
Antonio Banderas. Anthony Hopkins. Catherine Zeta-Jones in the network premiere. The Mask of Zorro, CBS Sunday.
The FBI has the top minds in law enforcement.
Pretty impressive piece of information gathering.
They have highly placed informants inside the mob.
What'd the Russians say?
Nothing bothers them commies.
Now.
NYPD, Mooney and Trout.
They're forced to work with New York's toughest cop.
They think they're gonna dress me down for doing my job?
From the co-creator of NYPD Blue, Ed O'Neill, Titus Welliver, David Strathairn, Michael Madsen, Donnie Wahlberg. Big Apple. Series premiere Thursday, March 1st.
Fitting right in.
What a love fest.
Wild, destructive teen girl.
Local people smile. Sun, fun, and great food. That's why we're introducing mini plate lunches. Just as tasty.